It was a Monday afternoon, May the 17th, 1875, on a brand new racetrack just south of Louisville, Kentucky. The second race of the day was the very first Kentucky Derby. 15 of the fastest three-year-old thoroughbreds went to the track, and 13 of the 15 jockeys that day were African-American. Black jockeys dominated the sport in the early years. In fact, 15 of the first 28 Derby winners were ridden by black jockeys, including maybe one of the best ever. Next to me, this is Isaac Murphy, who was the first jockey to win back-to-back Derbies and ended up winning the race three times. For Black History Month, we're gonna delve into the life of not a jockey, but a trainer. Ansel Williamson, who trained the very first Kentucky Derby winner named Aristides. And although not really much is known of Williamson's life, we hope from this episode that you'll be able to understand the passion that he had for the sport of kings. There was a farm, guys, right outside of Lexington, Kentucky during the Civil War. And by the way, guys, during the Civil War, Kentucky had something that both armies wanted. What do you think it was?
Horses.
Horses. Guys, both armies wanted one of those horses, and they were raiding these farms all over the Lexington Bluegrass region. And guys, the biggest and best farm was called Woodburn Farm. And the owner of Woodburn Farm was a guy named R.A. Alexander. I need a rich guy to come up here right now. A rich guy, Mr. R.A. Alexander. Let's get that guy right there. Come on up here.
Homer.
Everybody say hello, Mr. Alexander.
Hello, Homer.
Now, Mr. Alexander, you were kind of a rich guy, and tell you what, I'm going to get you a rich guy jacket right here. And what's your name? Mr. Alexander, that's your name. Mr. Alexander, put this on right here, if I can get this right. There you go, Mr. Alexander. And guys, one day, Mr. Alexander is sitting at his dinner table, have a seat right there, and there is a knock at the door. And standing at that door, ladies and gentlemen, is a guy in blue for the Union Army. And there he is right there. Uh-oh, this guy means business. Come on up here. Come on up here. And what's your name?
Cole.
Cole, you stand right there. Colonel Cole right here. Colonel Cole, you come and answer the door. Tell him, say, I want your horses. What are you gonna say? No. And guys, on that farm, there was the fastest thoroughbred in the United States. His name was Asteroid. And tell him, say, I want Asteroid.
I want Asteroid.
What do you tell him?
No.
No way. And guess what he's going to do? Take him anyway. He's going to take him anyway. And he stole all those horses, including Asteroid, and he made his getaway. Let's get out of here. He made his getaway. But ladies and gentlemen, R.A. Alexander had a lot of friends. When you're rich, you have lots of friends, I guess, right? And he got all of his friends together, and they chase after him. Chase after him, Alexander, and he finally catches up, don't go anywhere, and he says, look, Colonel Cole, I know I can't take my horses back, because you got all these soldiers, but I'm a rich guy, can I buy my horses back? And Colonel Cole says, sure, because you're just gonna go raid the neighbor's farm, aren't you? Yeah, okay? So, R. Alexander gave him a bunch of money. He gets his horses back, including Asteroid, and come on down here, Mr. Alexander. Your farm is now safe. Have a seat right there, guys. Give him a hand. His farm's safe. You can go back to your seat. The only trouble was, there was another army in Kentucky as well. And this army right here, there was a guy, his name was Sue Mundy. Yep, a boy named Sue. Okay, you probably don't know that song though, do you? Yeah. And ladies and gentlemen, I need somebody to be the vicious Sue Mundy. This guy was an outlaw, and he was a part of the Confederacy. And let's get this one right here. Come on up here. Here comes a boy named Sue. Come on up here.
Oh, Jacob.
And your name? Jacob, come here, Jacob. And Jacob is wearing the gray of the Confederacy right there. You stand right over here. Stand right over here and knocks on the door. And coming to the door right now is Mr. Alexander. Tell him what you want.
Horses.
What are you gonna tell him? Totally. Which horse do you really want?
Asteroid.
What do you say? No, say get out of here. But guys, here's the whole point of the story. Living on Mr. Alexander's farm, there was a horse expert named Ansel Williamson. He was a trainer.
Here in this area of Cemetery Number 2 in Lexington lies Ansel Williamson, who trained our very first Kentucky Derby winner. There's no stone. It's been lost over the years. And in fact, of the 5,000 people interred here, only several hundred stones are marked to mark the resting place of some of these great horsemen. But Ansel Williamson was born a slave before the Civil War. And during the Civil War, he was in Kentucky at Woodburn Farm and trained the great, great thoroughbred Asteroid. And Civil War guerrilla raiders came and they raided the farm. And Williamson even brought out the wrong horse. They told him they wanted Asteroid, but he went back and at gunpoint, he brought out another horse that turned out not to be Asteroid. So an incredible, incredible man who took so much pride in his work. After the Civil War, he stayed at Woodburn Farm, but as a free man. And then eventually, after Woodburn Farm was sold, Williamson went to work for H.P. McGrath of McGrathiana Farm here in Lexington. And it was working with McGrath that he trained Aristides. And of course, they went to Louisville in 1875 and won the very first Kentucky Derby. Williamson also trained the great Chesapeake, who was supposed to win that day. And also he trained a horse named Calvin, who won the Belmont that same year in 1875. Williamson lived into the 1880s, was very highly respected in society. And of course, as a great horseman, they called him Uncle Ants. A sign of respect, but it was in the 1880s that that Williamson died and was buried here at Cemetery Number 2.
And Ansel Williamson, who wants to be Ansel Williamson? This guy's pretty amazing right here. Ansel Williamson, you want to be Ansel? Come on up here, Ansel. Here comes Ansel. And your orders at gunpoint are to go get Asteroid. Okay? So you go get Asteroid. Come on over here, Ansel. You got the horse right here? Lead Asteroid over to that guy right there and hand him over. Okay? And what do you tell her? Thank you. Good, all right. So you ride away with Asteroid, okay? Why'd you do that? Why did you give him Asteroid like that so easy? And now I want you to say, well, he had a gun in his hand.
Well, he had a gun in his hand.
Exactly. But guys, you know what's pretty cool? What's pretty cool is, he's riding away on a horse, but it's not Asteroid. It looks like Asteroid, okay? But guys, you're riding away on a much slower horse, okay? And now guys, I want somebody to raise your hand and tell me, why would Ansel Williamson do that? Did that horse belong to Ansel Williamson? No, you took care of him, right? But why would Ansel Williamson do that? That's a deep, deep question, isn't it? What do you think?
So he wouldn't get the real horse.
Yeah, that's exactly right. But why would he risk his life? Because guys, if Sue Mundy over there knew that that was a fake, then not the right horse, what would have happened? There would have been violence. Yeah, I wouldn't want to have been in your shoes, actually. So why would Ansel Williamson do that? Guys, that's a very important question. What do you think?
I think he did that so he could turn himself. He would take the best horse.
Right. Guys, even though that Ansel Williamson didn't own that horse, guys, he certainly, because he took care of him every day, he felt a certain sense of pride and ownership, okay, in those horses he took care of, okay? Give them all a hand. Thank you very much, guys. Back to your shoes. Good job. All right, we're going to wrap up our program now, guys, because it wasn't soon after that Civil War was over that there was a guy that lived in Louisville, Kentucky. He lived in Louisville, Kentucky, and he is going to get the thoroughbred industry going again, ladies and gentlemen. Would you please welcome my last volunteer of the day? Would you please welcome Meriwether Lewis Clark Jr.? Who wants to be Meriwether Lewis Clark Jr.? Let's get this guy right here. What's your name? Where? All right. Everybody repeat after me. Say, Colonel. Meriwether. Lewis. Clark. Junior. And that's you. This guy lived in Louisville, Kentucky. You know what he said? He said, we got to get these thoroughbred farms going again. We got to get them going again. And what better way to do that than to have a big race? Trouble is, he didn't know that much about thoroughbred racing, so you know where he went? He went to England, where he met the richest person in the whole world. There you are. Look, it's the Earl of Derby. Come on up here, Earl of Derby. Now, the Earl of Derby that you were a while ago, that was your great-great-grandfather, okay? But you're also the Earl of Derby because that's a title that gets passed down. Tell him about that race that your great-great-grandpa came up with.
It's pretty great.
It's pretty great. What kind of horse?
Thoroughbred.
Well, how old?
3 years old.
What's the distance of the race?
1.5 miles.
Perfect. You know what he says? Colonel Clark says, I'm going to copy everything. And he did, guys. He patterned everything after you. Okay, so thank you for letting us copy. You can go back to your chair now. And he came back to Louisville where he was from, and he had a couple of uncles. Guess what their last name was? Churchill. You're sitting on their farm, what used to be their farm. He built a racetrack there, guys, and guess what? We're back to where we started. May the 17th, 1875, it was a Monday afternoon, we're gonna run the very first Kentucky
Derby.
15 horses went to the post. And guys, 13 of the 15 jockeys that day, they weren't slaves, were they?
No.
Slavery's done. But what were they? They were African American, including the winner. Oliver Lewis was his name. And guys, we go on through history. 15 of the first 28 Derby winners ridden by black jockeys. Guys, here we are today, getting ready for the 143rd running of this race. And of course, the Derby now is a big part of our culture. It's a big part of our history. Hey, sixth graders, it's also a big part of our economy.
Yep.
Okay? Thank you all so much. You all did a wonderful job.